The crew of the Victory is in for a wild ride. Image. Netflixio9 ReviewsReviews and critical analyses of fan-favorite movies, TV shows, comics, books, and more. The first and last half hours of Space Sweepers, Jo Sung-hee's new Netflix movie, have some of the grandest, most fun space action we're likely to see in a movie this year. It's got a bit of a problem, though. In between those chunks is another hour plus of movie that can't really decide what it wants to be until it's almost too late. After an explosive introduction to the ragtag crew of the salvage ship Victory, Devil May Care Captain Jang, Kim Tae-ri, ship pilot Tae-ho, Song Joong-ki, wild engineer Tiger Park, Jin Seon-kyu, and their snarky robot companion Bubs, voiced by Yoo Hae-jin, Space Sweepers slams the brakes on its momentum with all the strength of the massive harpooning cables the Victory uses to grab space junk floating in Earth's orbit, taking a step back to slowly build up its world. Set in 2092, when Earth's environment has been transformed into a toxic wasteland, the privileged elite of humanity has flocked into the arms of the UTS Corporation, led by self-appointed savior figure James Sullivan, Richard Armitage, joining a surprisingly vast cast of international actors beyond the primary Korean cast. UTS promises the rich a utopia in the stars, beginning with idealistic space colonies in Earth's orbit, while the poorest classes are left to choke to death on Earth, racking up corporate debt while making a living scraping valuable metals and minerals from space junk that threatens to enter Earth's orbit. Image. NetflixG Media may get a commissionIt against this background that Space Sweepers initially frames itself as an at times surprisingly dark piece of class commentary. Contrasting the seeming nobility of Sullivan and the UTS against our heroes, in the crew of the Victory, presented at first as cruel, selfish jerks who have all done bad things and are willing to do much worse to make a buck beyond their meager earnings as salvagers, the first hour or so of the movie is fascinating by a single question: in a society of haves and have-nots, what dark power does money hold over a person? It's a question examined across all sorts of characters we meet in Space Sweepers' world, from Sullivan's disconcerting view of human morality to both the crew's frustration with the capitalist slog they find themselves perpetually indebted to and the aforementioned sniping and greed that emerges when they're faced with the chance of earning even a few bucks more than usual. But it's one made personable when, on a routine teardown of a derelict ship, the team discovers a young girl named Dorothy, Park Ye-Rin, as a miraculous survivor. However, they quickly learn via news channels that she's a vastly advanced android hijacked by a terrorist organization and implanted with a massive bomb.